My name is Oliver Queen. After 5 years in hell, I returned home with only one goal, to save my skin. But my older folks wasn't enough. I had to become something else. I had to become something else. I had to become the Green Arrow. Previously on Arrow, someone else was throwing a hat in the ring.
Who? Ray Adams.
I'm Oliver.
He can't know that you're his father, and nobody else can.
I know who Oliver Queen cares about more than anyone.
Who?
His son.
Mayor Davis will be moderating the debate. There'll be a podium there, another one there, and according to tradition, the selection's made by some coin toss thingy.
Mr. Queen, at last we meet.
Ms. Adams, I'm just curious, is Adams your maiden name?
Oh, I'm not married, actually.
Really? Mm. Well, I'm sure you just haven't met the right person yet.
Well, it is lovely to finally meet you. An unconventional candidate, to say the least.
Bit of a dark horse yourself. Just meaning that your candidacy seems to have come out of nowhere.
Well, generally, I prefer to keep my philanthropic works quiet. But the city isn't simply too much trouble for me to remain in the shadows.
Yes, it is. The people destroying our homes need to be fought in the light of day.
Well, I hope that we have a productive debate, Mr. Queen.
I look forward to it. Miss Adams.
More like Mrs. Deceitful Dark.
I feel like Adams probably polls better.
It's not like we can prove that Adams isn't her real last name.
How is our opposition research coming?
Nothing yet. She's apparently clean, but the more we do digging into her and her background, the more likely she's going to dig into ours.
I guess our cue.
I really need you to take a look at these engagement party invites. My mom's been hounding me.
The envelope is very pink.
I know. We don't. Open it.
Should have totally seen that one coming.
I'm so sorry. What do you think?
Maybe less glitter.
You're getting glitter. Hey, let's move out.
Valley's bringing up her car.
I've almost got the eyeball. You should move.
Like she did the last 6 times we trailed her, you mean?
Yes, we coordinated with Dark somehow. We keep this up, we learn how, we find out where he is.
I've run out of room.
On it.
If he turns left on Will Central, we head home.
He's not, right? Could be our lucky night, sweetie. You're in.
Got her. Green Arrow, you ready for the handoff?
Already there. I've got eyes on.
With my husband the other week. He does not take kindly to being stood up. And he has a little something to say about you stalking his wife as well. We're not going to find Dark by tailing his wife.
Yeah, well, it's not like we have a lot of moves left to make. Dark is gone. Well, Dark ever since Majin attacked his family.
Dark is not afraid of Majin. It's just his plan's gone to a new phase.
But how do you know that?
Because I've spent months trying to cripple the city's leadership. They discourage people from running for mayor. They even tried to co-opt my candidacy.
Yeah, this is evil through her hat, that's right.
There has to be a reason. Dark did not try and destroy Star City so that his wife could be mayor. There's something we're not seeing.
Oh, I can see it. Clear as day. You on the podium Thursday night, vexing Oliver Queen with your political legerdemain.
Until we take him out of the game completely, you mean? Oh, you're not reconsidering the plan.
Malcolm Merlin reached out. Gave me an early birthday present. It would be a shame not to make use of it. Ah, my buddies! Let's get the rest of the organization on the line. Ladies and gentlemen, I am giddy to report that Phase 4 is proceeding on schedule.
There's still some concern about the Star City operation.
Enlighten me.
Phase 5 requires control over City Hall, yet somehow we've found ourselves mired in a petty political race to see that happen.
We didn't exactly plan on Oliver Queen, did we? No one ever does.
I think what Mr. Armitage is too polite to say is that Phase 5 now rests on your wife's questionable political action.
Tomas, how is Madrid this time of year? I remember taking a siesta in your office once. I can practically picture the room right now, as if I'm actually in it. Okay, then. Anything else to cover?
Well, there is the matter of Quentin Lentz.
He's clearly been aiding the vigilantes.
I can confirm as much. But don't worry. That loose end is about to be well tied.
Hi.
Hey. Time for my 8 o'clock feed already.
Funny. I thought you could use a little pick-me-up.
I think you used that excuse last week to check up on me. DA's office never worked with my department so much.
I'm worried about you.
No kidding.
No, Dad, seriously. Dark has to know that you're the one that gave up the ghost base operation.
And I go to work every day surrounded by men and women with guns. It is all right, sweetheart. It's all right. Hello. Lance. Yeah. Yeah. I'm going to be there in 10. Got a possible 602.
Isn't that a little below your pay range?
Yeah, and that's how short-handed we are.
Good. I'll come with you. I'll wait in the car, and then we can go for dinner.
I got plans for Donna.
That's even better. I've been wanting to spend some time with a woman that won over my father's heart.
Oh, wow.
Oh, I knew we should have played Wilson to the party planning. Hey, guys. I don't know how I'm going to get everything done in time. Maybe we should gamble. What?
I think what Felicity is trying to say is that we don't want you working too hard.
I don't consider this work. I think of it as a dry run for your wedding.
Mm-hmm.
So listen, we are going to have party favors over in that corner. We're going to have a champagne tower right here. And we're going to play games over by the fireplace. Oh, I brought my favorite. Pin the junk on the hunk.
Oh. Sorry, is this bad timing?
For who?
Is everything okay?
Yeah, we got a lot.
Yeah.
Where are you going?
Good calls. Sorry.
Is everything okay?
So Alex got a phone call from one of the lawyers doing research on the opposition, and it looks like they might have found something.
On Rube?
On you, actually. In 2013, Homeland Security did a tax audit after the undertaking, and it looks like Mom wrote a $1 million check to some woman named Samantha Clayton. I mean, Alex flagged it as something potentially weird for us.
What weird he means?
Well, the check was never cashed. So why would Mom write a check for $1 million to a woman young enough to be her daughter, and why would that woman not cash the check?
I don't know.
Should I look into this Samantha person?
Well, I don't really see the point in whatever was going on with this Samantha person. Clearly, she wanted nothing to do with Mom. And either way, I don't see how something like this would blow back on me. Thank you.
Okay.
Everything has unfolded according to promise.
Everything is under there anyway.
How, Mr. Queen? I'm glad you have recuperated. We have much to accomplish together. Writer's pack.
You don't know what you're talking about.
I know you killed Vlad. I watched. We all did.
What are you going to do? Kill him right in front of the writer's men?
They don't care what we do to him. They remember what he did to Conklin. Maybe you men need to go for a drink or something.
A 602's breaking and entering. Why would they need backup in the form of a police captain?
I told you, we're short-handed. But don't worry. It's not a job for Black Canary.
SCPD, anyone here?
Yeah, this is Lance. Give me dispatch.
Come on.
your cigar.
What happened?
Your guess is as good as mine. It's like the big bad wolf huffed and puffed or something.
This wolf being Dark. Why do you think they went through so much trouble to make it look like an accident?
Maybe they want to take the heat of killing a police captain. Thanks for the appointment.
Where are you going?
Yeah, Damien Dark has you in his gun sights. It might not be a good idea to show yourself an open.
I'm meeting with Donna.
Oh, she's fine. She's probably just playing in the junk on the hunk or something.
What?
Do not ask. Do not ask.
Stay here for a minute. Let us do what we do.
Let them go check with Andy. See if he's ever seen Hive use these tactics before besides on daddy duty. Not at Lila's to handle Argus.
I'm going to try and fax the call that supposedly came from dispatch.
I am
going to go work on your debate prep.
Yeah. Debate prep. Just took the words right out of my mouth.
Yep.
This man deserves to die. He tortured us.
And he saved me. At great risk to himself, he kept me alive. I have more reason than anyone to hate this man. But he deserved his chance of going home.
He killed your brother.
Yes, he did. Tell them when.
The guard called him. He put blood out to him. I was defending myself. He attacked me. I know that you have no reason to trust me, but I'm not your enemy. All I want of you is stop Ryder and get all of you out of this place. So prove it. How? Kill Conklin. See each other for a while.
What?
Yeah, it's a thing I got into. I owe some guys some money.
You gamble. Yeah. Mr. Straight and Narrow?
Yeah, I know you helped me cope after we quit drinking. And I pissed out some pretty tough customers.
Wait. Hi. Quick. Please. I'm a Vegas girl, okay? Whomever you owe money to is going to have to get up pretty early in the morning to take me on. Don't worry.
It's a little more complicated than that. Just for a few weeks. That's all.
You know, how about we make it longer?
What?
My ex-husband was a lying son of a bitch. Only two good things came out of that marriage, my daughter and my BS detector, which is flawless. And right now, yeah, it's redlining.
Donna, please don't please.
Oh, my God. Don't dawn on me. You know what? This is actually very simple. You either respect me enough to tell me the truth or you don't.
Why do you think it's me that did something?
Because you're a man.
I'm trying to put some distance between us. In case Doc is after me, because I can't stand the idea of anything happening to Felicity.
Yeah, she's pretty upset.
Yeah. I hope it's not you.
I'm looking for you. I found something.
The 602 didn't come from SCPD dispatch at all. Someone just made it look like it did.
That's someone being Hive, you're thinking.
There's an encryption on it that uses the same cipher of a Hive sat phone that Merlin gave us.
One more time. They lured you to the hotel. Do we know where the call came from?
Bryson 14th. A bunch of other calls came from there as well. I'm guessing it's their base of operation.
Okay, contact the team and have them meet me there.
Yep.
Scrap. Job seems easy enough.
Don't get cocky. Dark won't tolerate another screw up. Where's Jack?
Patrolling.
Let's go.
tell him. You guys go get a partner, okay? I'm gonna get the laptop.
Edie,
you go!
Hey!
Tell me that the nails are the clue and not what's on the laptop's hard drive, because there are three nails running straight through the thing.
Yeah, that guy's been a little crazy with that nail gun.
Yeah, according to Andy, they call the demolition team. From the GRU, IRA, and Mossad. They're experts in precision demolition.
Now they work for Hive.
I got a look at the laptop before it got shot up, and there were blueprints on the screen.
So they were going to take down another building.
Felicity?
I know. The first time we met, the first thing you asked me to do was pull data off a damaged laptop. Kind of romantic.
In case the laptop is a dead end, I am going to work up a list of potential targets.
Yeah, Andy's supposed to get some more intel. I'll see if he's made any progress.
Oh, Mom. Wonder what took her so long.
What is that about?
Donna called it quits.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that.
Yeah, me too. You're lucky you're with someone you don't need to keep secrets from.
Are these really necessary?
Damn, risk you jeopardizing your life again. Much too important.
Now, you keep saying that to me, but I have no idea what you mean.
Do you believe in destiny, Mr. Quinn?
I prefer the idea of free will.
This map conceals deeper truths, secrets I couldn't uncover without more information until you brought these to me.
Except I didn't bring them to you. Conklin took them.
Destiny, Mr. Quinn. With the survey map's details, I was able to decipher the inscriptions on this, which you also provided me. Are you beginning to see it now? The pattern? The trend of providence? Legend tells of a hidden place, within which lies a device of untold power. The quest to find it requires one who has been granted passage by the gods. I believe that person is you.
Hi. You're needed upstairs.
Keep Mr. Quinn company till I return. We still have much to discuss.
All this magic mumbo-jumbo. Maybe it saved your neck with Ryder. Maybe I ought to start believing in it myself. Ain't easy when it looks like toilet paper.
Boy, you got so much.
I'm enjoying watching you die.
I didn't want to bother you when you walked in on us at Oliver's campaign office, but I'm...
It's okay.
No, honey, no.
Yeah, no, it's not. It's actually not okay.
It's okay.
After your father, after all these years, I thought I finally found the one man who wouldn't lie to me, okay?
Maybe he's got a good reason.
Yeah. Honey, I want you to know that I'm really sorry that I've been going all momzilla for this engagement party. Do you want to know why I pushed the tiaras and the 10-tier cake?
Well, that's because you've loved princesses since before you could walk.
Yes, that and, you and Oliver are one of those couples that everyone believes in. You don't lie to each other. Ever. And he's going to be the best daddy in the whole world when that time comes. I know that, don't you?
I never won't.
I want to say something. That beautiful. And that rare and that romantic. It also reminds me that, you know, I'm never going to find a love like that.
Yes, you will. You have it now, Captain Lance.
No, honey, no. Not if he's hiding something from me.
Maybe he's doing it to protect you. Because he loves you. And you need to return that love with a little bit of trust.
Crime, healthcare, taxes, business incentives. Actually, pretty much nailed them all.
Stop sounding so surprised, please.
Well, I mean, you did spend your education nailing chicks, not doing social studies.
Okay. I'm sort of wiped. Can we wrap this up, maybe?
Yeah, I did have one more question for you.
Okay.
Why didn't you tell me you went to college with Samantha Clayton?
I was with Samantha Clayton while I was dating Laurel. And I'm not proud of that, so...
So why didn't Mom pay her $1 million.
Yeah, I told you. Love is...
Ollie, I looked her up. Right after you guys broke up, she moved to Central City. She's got a son. And William. He's about as old as that Chuck is.
Okay. Yeah.
When we were in Central City, I knew something was bothering you. I knew it just wasn't Vandal Savage. But now it makes sense. William's your son, isn't he?
Yes, he is.
Why haven't you told anyone?
Because Samantha said that the only way that I could see him is if I promised to not tell him or anyone else that I'm his father.
That is brutal. Are you okay?
I thought I was doing okay. I spent a lot of time convincing myself that I was trying to do the right thing. But then, you know, you brought this, the thing, the check, and it's not your fault, but it's... bring it up right when we're trying to plan an engagement party. So I'm left to think, how can I marry Felicity if there's this lie between us?
It's not a lie. Okay, it's a promise that you are keeping to the mother of your child.
It doesn't make it right, Thea.
Look at it from Samantha's perspective. As far as she knows, you are a rich playboy who slept with a bunch of women and got her pregnant.
I'm not that person anymore.
Now you're the Green Arrow. Anyone who comes into your life is automatically a target. What Samantha is asking for you to do, as hard as it may be, it is the right thing to do. I know you want to tell Felicity, and trust me, I would love to be an aunt. But you have got to do the right thing for your son here. As hard as this may be for you, Ollie, keeping William a secret is keeping him safe.
Yes, John.
Ant did a little digging on the dark web. Found out the demolition team uses a specialized asset that can weaken building structures. Only one warehouse in the city stocks.
Text me the address. I'll be right there. No, just it's a long shot. Best.
Yeah.
Thank you.
For what?
Just saying what I need to do here.
Curtis, why is my face your screensaver?
At the risk of early termination, none of your business.
Curtis.
Oh, please don't ask. I'm, like, super bad with secrets. Okay, it's an early wedding gift, but it's really bad if you see it, so please stop trying to see it.
Okay, I think you're getting your wedding traditions confused, but fine, I will let it go. Lucky for you, I have more important concerns. I maxed out the computer power in Lair again, and I was hoping maybe your mainframe might have better luck.
I'll do my best.
Thank you. Really, we have a screensaver. Whatever the surprise is, it better be good.
Oh, it will be.
Well, that's not your typical nighttime suit.
You're the reason I'm wearing it. Hiring me to save a city in the light of day?
For any inspiration, I turned out to be hiding down here in the dark for your protection.
You haven't told Donna, have you?
No. You kept this stuff for 4 years, huh? There's a double life, there's secrets, lying. I mean,
I'm trying not to live that way anymore. Trying.
You know, in AA, we say you're only as sick as the secrets you keep. You're looking pretty healthy these days. I just hope I can get back to that place with Donna.
For what it's worth, you're in a tough spot, and you're trying to keep her safe. Sometimes a lie isn't wrong, it's for the good of someone that you love.
So you know, after I'm done with you, I'm gonna gut that slave girl just for kicks. All the rest of them, too.
You're never hurting them ever again. There he is. There's the killer.
Ravine's probably going to question you and her party boy past, but if she does,
just steer the conversation back towards the issues. I've got it. Yeah. Alex's mom kind of picked the wrong week to go in for surgery, don't you think?
Okay, couldn't agree more. We got about 20 minutes until we're live, so how are you feeling? Are you nervous at all? Or, you know, I don't think that nervous is in Oliver's vocabulary.
That's what translucent matte powder should be. You don't want to shine under those big,
the right lights?
Hey, why do we even need makeup? We're not even going to be on stage.
Plus, I love makeup.
Mom. I gotta take this.
Oh, okay. You know what? I'm going to be right back. I hate this. It's a horrible powder puff. It's awful.
That was fast.
You sound surprised. I don't know whether to be flattered or insulted.
Okay, Curtis, what did you get?
Not much. Just a set of blueprints. Pretty underwhelming considering. I'm uploading it to you now.
Curtis, I gotta call you back. Oliver, I need you.
What's wrong?
I know what building Hive is planning on taking down. It's this one. Okay, I have a million questions, but first, why would Hive try to attack the debate?
To take me out, discourage anyone else from running.
Okay, but Dark's wife is here at Ground Zero, so it doesn't really make sense.
Unless Dark's demolition team is going to wipe everyone out except Wu Fei.
Leaving Mrs. Dark a sympathetic survivor instead of the pot of evil stew that she actually is.
Can you identify the likely areas the bombs would be?
Yeah, according to the schematics, it's these 3 points, but this building is huge.
We need to split up and cover more ground.
Okay, good, then we've got to change our clothes.
Call Laurel and Diggle. Can you hack the fire alarm? We need to evacuate the building.
It's an old system. It might take me a minute.
Yeah, I learned that in high school.
Listen to me very carefully. Change of plan. Do not let all the queen leave this building alive.
Copy that. Hey, I finally found it. Where's Oliver and Thea?
Well, they're probably just in time, making sure everyone gets out of bed.
You left them inside?
Hey, come on, we need to go help them. Let's go.
Here's the street.
Not here.
What kind of cop sits on the sidelines and people's lives are risked, huh?
Everywhere, except for the bathroom, apparently.
Sorry. Nervous bladder, I think.
Oh, that was something I never needed to hear, ever. Are you ready to go?
Whatever.
Yeah.
Oh, come on.
Captain Lance never lets his man get away. You shouldn't either.
Just
despite a bomb threat. Tonight's mayoral debate then went on as scheduled, with Mr. Queen being declared by most pundits the clear winner.
Of course he's the clear winner. He's marrying my daughter.
Well, I think you're a little biased.
Did Alex call with the new poll numbers?
Well, that least sounds right. He doesn't have to. Experts are saying that you already won.
Experts aren't the voters.
Okay. Well, we at least have one vote in your camp.
Matters. Conklin may have had his difficulties, but he was a good man.
Yeah, he was a good man who attacked me. Self-defense.
As it was with her brother?
I'm not saying it lacks irony.
I need you alive, Mr. Queen. But there are different forms of alive. Don't test me again.
Ah!
You did it.
What was that for?
Thank you.
I don't know. Thanks, Diana. Before he died, Conklin told me the writer was going to kill him, Levi E. We don't have much time.
John, can I introduce you to Laura Hoffman?
Laura. Oh, don't mind if I do. John, hi.
Laura was our neighbor in Ivytown. She drove all day to get here.
Please, the drive was nothing. I've been waiting 5 months for this moment to finally arrive. Oh, hey, have you started your wedding registry yet? Because I may very well have the perfect gift idea for you.
Oh, let me guess. Slow cooker.
How did you know that?
I'm telepathic.
Excuse me. Sorry to interrupt, but I need you both. Photographer is here. Did you invite him?
Oh, me?
Sorry, could I talk to you for a minute?
Yes, absolutely.
Good to Felicity.
What? The photographer's right over there. We will make it there. Just fine by.
I see. Please. It's quite the party you got going on here.
What? What do you want to talk about?
Oh, I came here to apologize because you were right. I lied to you because I was afraid how you would react to the truth. The thing I was worried about. It wasn't a gambling problem. It was Hive. The same people
that hurt my baby. Why wouldn't you tell me that?
Because I'm not gonna say. Because I'm free from it. I'm not gonna say. Because I stopped working for them.
You were working with Damien Dark?
Laurel. And the truth is, I'm glad Dark came after me and not her. Because if he'd done it,
you were protecting her. Just like you're protecting me.
A moment.
Hello.
Okay.
Oh,
I thought you
came for that champagne. Dr. Queen, I do believe you are right.
Curtis, Paul! I'm glad you guys made it. Quick, grab a glass of this champagne.
Careful, he might drink the entire bottle.
I like my bubbly, what can I say? Mixing a downer with all the coffee you've had in the last 72 hours, your head might explode.
Yeah, I have been going a lot of crazy hours. After my surprise was blown on my gift, I wanted to finish it as soon as possible.
We forgot to register for a microchip.
Actually, it's neither a micro nor a chip. It's an implantable biostimulant.
And why would I need an implantable biostimulant?
For walking. Curtis, in a perfect world, it'll work in time for you to walk down the aisle. I mean, but it's pretty cutting edge, as I can't promise anything.
You're telling me that the full piece of technology is going to help me walk again?
After it's implanted in your spine, yes.
He's been trying to crack it for a while, but you need your power source. Something that will last a lifetime.
Home Technologies power cell.
Exactly. Once I solved that, I knew this might actually work.
Oh, my God. I don't know what to say.
I do. Curtis, you're terrific. Thank you.
Well, don't thank me yet. It still has to work.
It'll work. I know it will. You, come with me. We're about to make another. Very.
Hi, sweetie. Nora, honey, there's someone I'd like you to meet.
Nora? This is William. William's mother asked us to look after him. He'll be staying with us for a while.
Nice to meet you, William. Want to play?
Sure.
Rick, move your head.